Doctor Who, Tyler Victorious, issue 2 of Monstrous Beauty, the second or the third issue storyline featuring the Ninth Doctor, was a contribution from Doctor Who magazine dealing with the Tyler Victorious storyline. And I will say this, this is better than issue 1, because here's the thing, these issues are 20 pages long. 60 pages for the entire story, right? And for 20 pages for a first issue, it's a lot to uncover here, because, you know, we know Doctor Who, we know how the Ninth Doctor is, and how, you know, Woe's Axe is, and, you know, all those type of things. But we are trying to be introduced to this new world, like the Dark Times, and Gallifreyans who don't, you know, who are not Time Lords, and this war, and vampires, and you're trying to pack all these things while also trying to hit the story points that you as a writer is trying to hit. And it did felt very packed together. It did felt like we're trying to do world building at the same time trying to tell this appealing story dealing with vampires. And with this one, it just is it's a very simple story. It's the Doctor trying to find Rose and finding out who has taken her. What have they done to her? Is she okay? Has something happened to her? And of course, with Nine, she, you know, the Doctor feels very responsible of anything bad happening to Rose, because he's like, I just took this girl into the TARDIS, show her time and space, and now she's stuck with me, and unsent me, so she's locked, and it's all my fault. He feels that level of responsibility that comes around with it, but he's, you know, still the Doctor, he's still Nine, and, you know, him all going all, you know, he's serious, but he's joking at the same time, and all that type of stuff, and it just glows pretty well. I mean, hell, there's this one character of a name I can't announce, but, you know, he's the scientist, and that the relationship between Nine and the scientist character is wonderfully well done. And you, like, the ending, you just feel the I had goosebumps reading the ending of this. And you're thinking, geez, like, knowing, you know, because of The Night, the Fallen, and the Dead, knowing that and how it ends up with the cliffhanger, your head thinking, okay, this has happened, this needs to happen to lean up to the story, to that point. And you need, your head's like, how do you resolve that, and how do you cliffhanger that to a point it feels satisfying to enough that, hey, here's a solid three-act Doctor Who story dealing with Nine and Woes, while at the same time trying to tie things together with the full event of Time of Victoria. So, yeah, I mean, this is a well more better read than issue 1. And I'm really curious how they're going to wrap this side of the story of it. The final contribution is next month. Actually, the first thing next month, because this is the final thing for October, is a issue of... It's a second audio drama. I was trying to think, is it the Daleks first? But it's the My Enemy of My Enemy in the Daleks. It's My Enemy of My Enemy is The Enemy of My Enemy, which is the second Eighth Doctor audio drama. So, yeah, it's really well done. The art is pretty well put together. And more, it's a really straightforward, more easy paced story with Monstrous Beauty, issue 2.